Sawa jama.
Maybe Kedlo, you can introduce yourself and tell us what your reactions towards the launch of BBIG at the Bombers game.
My name is Advocate Gacheru Afande, and first is to wish our president happy birthday, and also for today a robust discussion of the Bombers at the Bombers of Kenya in regard to the release of the BBI. And I want to say that what is happening in Kenya is agreed by the Constitution of the Republic of Kenya in Article 255, 256 and 257 of the Constitution, that a constitution can be changed at any time in our Republic by either any person or a body or through a bill through Parliament and then be brought to the people. So what I'm saying is that what is happening in the country is not illegal, but it's within the constitutional framework. But more to that, we can see the BBI report. We have seen a divergent view in the Bombers of Kenya. But our position is that the BBI, as it is, has two sides. There are some those areas that the people feel they are okay, and there are some areas that people feel they are not proper. For example, in the BBI, there is the issue of the IBC, whereby the officials have been proposed that they should be selected by the major political parties or players. And I want to say that we say that you cannot be a judge in your own case, and therefore what we would expect is that there should be a proper discussion on the running and the appointment of the officers within the IBC, so that we can have an objective and an independent body as stipulated even in the 2010 Constitution. There is also the issue of the judiciary, which turns out to be a bit contentious. What we are saying is that the independence of the judiciary should not be compromised. We remember there was time the judiciary were acting on the whims of the executive. And what we are seeing is that if the office of the ombudsman is the one to read the appointment and the checks of the affairs of the judiciary, it implies that the independence of the judiciary will be compromised by the executive. And then we will not expect proper running affairs of the judiciary as a branch of the government. What we need is the issue of checks and balances. We don't expect that the BBI, whoever proponent, that we should have an imperial or presidency or executive, whereby other bodies will be subjected to control without any checks and balances by the other branches of government. On the other hand, we can see the BBI has also some good things that are in its content. For example, we have seen there is an issue of increasing the money to the counties from 15% to 35%. These are good proposals and which we would say we like to embrace, because there has been cries by the county government that the money they are receiving is not sufficient. There is also the issue of the tax holidays among the youth, the youth, whereby they are not expected to be subject to tax compliance or the payment limiting of taxes after they leave school for some years. But I think that's a good gesture to the youth. It is giving them to give them morale. What we are saying is that what the president has been saying and what he has repeated, and what is our perspective, is that this is the period we should have a proper constitutional debate to those who are supporting and those who are not supporting. And everyone should be listened if he or she gives a proper reason why a certain clause should not be carried in the amendments of the Constitution.
And maybe there's this issue of scrapping the seat of women at taking it to the Senate. What's your view on that?
I want to say that the introduction of the seat for the women lab was because the women were marginalized, and women wanted to be given a place to participate in the politics of the country. But what we have seen is just a change of name, maybe from women lab to the senator. Now we have the Senate having 94. I think the only issue is that women are being told to go to the Senate, when in fact some powers have been removed from the Senate through the BBI, because there's proponent that they will not be having a say in the financial matters. And I think if you want to have women have a robust debate in this country, is that they should go where there is actual debate, even the issue of finance in our republic. And what we are saying that when we are discussing the issue of either women going to the Senate and scrapping that seat, it means that the women should also join the Senate and be able to join the proper discussion of the affairs of this country, in regard even to financial matters.